From the stage of the Ryman Auditorium in Nashville, Tennessee, the country music capital of the world, here's the 1054th broadcast and the 21st Christmas show of the Grand Ole Opry. Tonight, starring George Morgan.
Well, you better watch out. You better not cry. Better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. He's making a list and checking it twice. Gonna find out who's naughty and nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. He knows if you've been bad or good. So be good for goodness sake. Watch out, you better not cry, better not pout, I'm telling you why, Santa Claus is coming to town.
Here's Sammy Pruitt now.
Hello.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
George Morgan, all set to sing us some great Christmas songs and put us in the proper holiday spirit. Welcome, George. Welcome to the Opry. It's a pleasure to have you here with us tonight.
Well, it's good to be here, Grant. As a matter of fact, it's good to be anywhere and out of the cold and away from all those last-minute Christmas shoppers.
Yeah, especially when you're in such good company, George, like Cousin Minnie Pearl and Archie Campbell.
Chet Atkins and Grandpa Jones, Tommy Jackson, Ralph Sloan, and all the Tennessee travelers.
And featuring the voices of our well-known...
Yes, the Jordanaires.
The Jordanaires will be singing some special Christmas songs for us in just a few minutes. Right now, it's time we heard from Santa's little helper, who has been busy up in East Tennessee, Archie Campbell!
Hello, Arch. George, wait a minute. I can't work from that side, boy.
How are you, Arch? Merry Christmas.
I'm left-eared.
Are you? Can't work from that
side. Merry Christmas to you.
Well, I'm glad to see you.
You know, I'm all upset. I've got to find something for my wife. I ain't got no Christmas present for my wife yet. I got to get her something.
No Christmas present for your wife. Let me see. Would you be interested in something in silk stockings?
Well, sure. But I got to get my wife something for Christmas first.
Oh, Arch.
Hey, Grandpa!
Hey, I gotta get you something for Christmas. I don't know what in the world it'll be.
By granny, you better get it in a hurry, because Christmas is pretty nigh here. If you're gonna get me something, get it.
Well, how about a jug of wine?
No, I don't drink.
You don't drink? Well, what about a horse?
No, I don't ride.
A shotgun?
I don't hunt.
Well, I know what I could get you. A bottle of perfume.
Bottle of perfume? Why is that?
Well, I know you smell.
Yeah. Too many old men on this show.
Yes, yes.
I like to go up home and play them games they play up there. We play games at Christmas time, you know.
Do you really?
Yeah. We got one game that I really enjoy up there at Bull's Gap. We play Christmas Tree.
Now, wait just a minute. How do you play Christmas Tree?
Well, you just get off in the corner and get lit up.
All right. Arch, I'm going to let you in on a secret. Yeah. I'm going to tell you what I got you for Christmas this year.
Did you get me something?
I got you something very nice. This year, I got you a pair of long handles.
A pair of long handles?
Yeah.
Lord, I wish you hadn't done that. I got a pair. Them things is dangerous.
What do you mean, dangerous?
I got up this morning, it is chilly, and I thought I'd put my... I got them out there, I was about half asleep, and I got them on upside down and backwards.
You mean you got your long handles on upside down and backwards?
Yes, sir. That's the first time I ever brushed my teeth through a trap door.
Good night, Art. Archie Campbell, the sage of Bull's Gap. Thank you, Archie. Thanks a lot. But now, George.
Yes, Grant, what's on your mind?
Well, it's guest time. So would you do the holiday honors and introduce our guests?
I'll be glad to, Grant. But you know, these boys don't need any introduction. They've been favorites here at the Opry for a long time. And just in case you don't know who I mean, here they are, folks. The Jordanaires. Here they come out now. Gordon, Hoyt, Neil, and Ray, welcome to the big Christmas show, and I see you've brought some lovely young ladies along with you. Don't tell me these are Christmas presents for me.
Not on your life, George. For the special Christmas songs we're going to do, these young ladies, Mary, John, and Millie, are going to sing with us.
Oh.
You know, it makes singing a little bit better, boys and girls.
Yeah, I know. And just about anything else you want to name, Gordon. But right now, how about a demonstration of that singing ability? Here they are, the new Jordanaires, with a great favorite about this time of year, Go Tell It on the Mountains.
Each and every one of you joined them in dancing. Thanks so much, Tommy and Dancers. That was wonderful. Wasn't that great, George?
Oh, it certainly was, Grant.
You know, when it comes right down to it, I think that that's one of the best parts of Christmas. Young folks getting together and having a good time.
Oh, Christmas means a lot of things, Grant.
It means a spirit of giving, of receiving, of peace on earth to men of goodwill. It has a great and wonderful religious meaning.
That of all things, George.
You're right. And at Christmas time, Grant, our thoughts turn more than ever to our friends, to our loved ones. And as the wind blows colder, as the store windows blaze with a sparkle of gay things and holly wreaths and candles twinkle brightly in the windows and doorways, then more than ever, our thoughts turn homeward. And each and every one of us, like the person in the song, says to ourselves, I'll be home for Christmas. You can plan on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents on the tree. Christmas Eve will find me audience.
That was beautiful, George. Now, what do you say we get on with the show as another of our Opry favorites steps into the spotlight to play a medley of Christmas songs, your friend and mine, Chet Atkins. Songs. Thank you, Chet. Thanks a lot. Now here's another star of the Grand Ole Opry and our own Christmas girl, who brought along her own mistletoe, Cousin Minnie Pearl.
I never could.
Well, I was feeling so good tonight and everything full of the Christmas spirit and had this fine, lovely song here by George that was so pretty, George. That is just beautiful. And then Chet played that fine, fine Christmas music. And just as I started to come out of here feeling so good, well, one of them fellers back there grabbed me and stuck a sticker on my mouth, said, "Do not open until Christmas." That made me so mad. I could eat a banana. Well, too, though, I'm getting ready to do the last of my Christmas shopping, and I need a man to help me decide on what to get for my feller Hezzy. I wonder if I could find a man. Oh, Archie, come here. Archie Camel. Now, you ain't a man, but as much as I can. I don't know. But you'll just have to do, because I want to ask you. You look like you need to say something and want to be included in things, you know.
Minnie, I do want to be included. And if there's anything I can do to help you out, just ask me.
Well, I want to get a Christmas present for my feller Hezzy.
Yeah.
And I want to get something, you know, that he like. And I want you to give me any suggestions. You
well,
know?
I'll do the best I can. Let's see now, Minnie. I want...
Something that'll please him, you know.
Does he like you?
Yes, he likes me.
Oh, well, if he likes you, he'll like anything.
Oh, hush. That's not very nice.
Well,
I'd be ashamed of myself.
Yeah, saw Uncle Nabob today.
Did you?
Yeah, he's down
there. Was he up here in town?
Yeah, he's down here. Down here at the photographer's getting his picture made.
Really? Uncle Nabob having his picture?
For Aunt Ambrosie.
Yeah.
And he's getting his picture made for her. He's going to surprise her.
Oh, well, it will be a surprise. She's expecting a new coat. But I'll tell you about him. I tell you, though, about Uncle Nabob, I hope that surprise don't turn out like the last one he had.
What is that, Minnie?
Well, he was going to surprise Aunt Ambrosie. See, she'd been after him to get a new suit.
Yeah.
And so he will come into town and got him a brand new suit in a box, all fixed up, you know.
Yeah.
And as he started home, he had that old horse and buggy, and he started to ford the creek, and the creek was up. We'd had a lot of rain.
Yeah.
Just as he got in the middle of the creek, you know, he stopped to let the horse drink.
Yeah.
And just about that time, he thought, well, I'll just surprise Ambrosie. Said, I'll just take off this old suit and put on this new suit and walk in there and really surprise her.
With that new suit on?
Yeah, so he took off all his clothes, every one of them, you know, and put on... Just as he started to put on all them new clothes, all of a sudden, the horse shied right quick, and the new suit, old suit, box, and everything just went floating off down the river.
Thanks.
Right down the creek, and there he stood.
Jaybird.
Yes, he did. He said, well, I'll just go on like I am. I'll surprise her anyway. Well, no, now, really, y'all think I just say a lot of things, but Archie, now, I'm hurt because I gave you a nice Christmas present last year and you never even used it.
I know it, by grace, and I'm not going to either.
I give Archie a half a dozen of the finest white handkerchief that you ever seen.
Yeah.
I paid a lot for them, too. I paid $1.50 for every one of them handkerchiefs.
I know it. That's just too much money to blow in.
Oh, hush, Archie. Well, I hope you've got a present for me.
I have. Minnie, I've got the finest present that any woman would ever want for you.
Well, I want you to come over to my house Christmas because we've got it all fixed up with mistletoe and everything, and I'm going to be right there.
Is that right?
Yeah, mistletoe over every door.
Well, you ought to watch that. That's bad.
What?
That mistletoe business, that means you're going to kiss everybody that walks under it.
If I'm able. Yes, sir, I sure am.
Well, Minnie, I want to tell you something, buddy. That kissing spreads germs.
Well, you know any better way to meet a germ? No, tell me about your Christmas present.
I never did meet a germ.
Tell me about your Christmas present you got for me.
Minnie, I've got you. Come here, we'll get back on it.
go ahead. They're going to fuss at us. Tell me about the Christmas present.
I've got you the nicest Christmas present any woman.
Really? What is it?
Any woman in the world would want this present.
They'd be happy to have it, huh?
Yeah.
What is it?
Me.
Oh, quit! Get away from there! Bye now! See you next week!
Time we heard from the Jordanaires once again, so here they are with another great Christmas song, Silver Bell. Wonderful singing. We all enjoyed every minute of it. But now it's time for another treat. You know, no Christmas show, and certainly no Grand Ole Opry Christmas show, would be complete without the music of one of our favorites, as he and his lovely wife, Ramona, give us their version, and believe me, there's no other version like it, of Jingle Bells. So let's have a big hand for our old friend and his cowbells, Grandpa Joe. Here he is right here. Child, a treat makes joy bells ring on heaven's street. It isn't too late for you to make some youngster happy and bring a smile to the face of him whose birthday we celebrate this season. And now, Jordanaires, Archie Campbell, Minnie Pearl, Chet, Grandpa, everybody,
Won't you please join me as we sing that Christmas song that's as ageless and timeless as the day we celebrate? Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child. Christmas show draws to an end. And words can't say how wonderful it was having you with us. This is George Morgan speaking for all of us and saying, Merry Christmas. We'll be seeing you next week at the Grand Ole Opry. Good night, everybody.
Here's an old holiday custom that's still observed in parts of Europe and America. On Twelfth Night, a cake is served containing a bean and a pea. The man who gets the bean is Twelfth Night King, while the girl who finds the pea is queen. In Scandinavian countries, an almond is hidden in the rice pudding on Christmas Eve. Whoever finds it wins a prize. Except in Sweden, where it's an omen of marriage within the coming year. The plum pudding served in English homes at Christmas often contains a thimble, coin, or ring, bringing good luck to the finder. Another such token is the coin hidden in St. Basil's pie, served in Greece at New Year's. Each country has its own Christmas traditions. And as we share these traditions of others, we share in our hearts the spirit of Christmas, the spirit of hope and joy, and the wish for peace on earth.
Christmas holiday presentation of the United States Armed Forces Radio and Television Service.